I started in 1974. Well, my friend gave me a call and said that the Holy Name was looking for an athletic director. And I thought, well, I have three kids in college, one in high school, one at Holy Name, and a little munchkin three-year-old at home. And I thought, gee, I need something to do. So I went down and I applied and I got the job. The thing that impressed me and touched me the most is watching the girls finally hitting the ball over the net, hitting the baseball and getting on first base for the first time, and making their first basket in the basketball game. The look on her face is priceless. And I think that's the most exciting part that I really love with the girls.
She was clear on what she expected of the coaches, and it was all about the kids. And that's my philosophy too, it's all about the kids. So, and I like that. It wasn't about the trophy, it wasn't about the wins, it was how well the kids felt about themselves and also improved their skills while they were playing the sport.
They can't all be academically brilliant, but they can excel in sports. And I think it brings a lot out of them, you know, to be able to do something that they feel good. I think the boys always came first and the girls got left over. We played softball, and it was freezing because the gym was being taken care of. You know, everything evolved around the boys' sports. But I think it's gotten a lot better.
And they said they were looking for a coach. And I said, nah, I don't think so. And then when she said it was for a girls' team, I thought, my God, what am I going to do with girls? Well, it all worked out. So if they didn't have a coach, they wouldn't have a team. So everything worked out well, and 17 years later, I stopped coaching girls.
I think we got together and kind of tried to change things for the girls. Basketball and baseball and volleyball. The girls.
Okay, and just them being here and having
access. Yeah, they're marvelous. They really are. I got an education from them. When my little munchkin finally got in fourth grade here, she was real tiny, about the second smallest in the class. And she could dribble, being a gym rat for so many years, dribble the ball and really run fast. So one day, she could never make a basket. She wasn't strong enough, I guess, to get the ball up, but she tried. So one night we had a game here, and she stole the ball and dribbled her heart out down the other end, put the ball up, and it went in. The look on her face was priceless. She turned around. Oh my goodness, my team's up here. I just made 2 points for St. Cecilia's.
I think she did it because she just liked kids. I mean, she had six of her own, and she just enjoyed being around the kids all the time. And then as her children got older, she could kind of relive their childhood again, I think, working with younger kids at school.
She was instrumental in getting the girls' program going. And I think her sincerity and people felt that. And she wanted girls to have an equal program as like the boys. So I think parents sensed that. So she encouraged the girls here to come out and play and enjoy themselves and learn and have that sportsmanship together. And I think the parents seeing that also encouraged their daughters to go try out, play. It's a program for you.
And what do you think, how do you think your family and your kids and your husband helped you for the 18 years?
Oh, total support. I couldn't have done it without them. The oldest one is Susie, and Colleen. Patty's the one that was coach. Sean, Donnie, and Janine is the baby.
And your players, what are some things, some tangibles you think they learned that they took?
Being a good sport, I think, is one of the main things that I try to instill in the girls. I hope it's changed for the better. Girls can do anything a boy can do. And they're finally getting in their own to show that they can.